round. Good round.
Yeah, it was round.
Beautiful Ariane, thank you. That was actually the first single from our brand new album, which is going to be released on April the 3rd. And we actually have a few copies of it here as on advance release, so it's the only place on the planet that you can buy it. It's even in Chippewa Falls. And we were very lucky the other day we got invited into a Fox News studio to go and do a performance of that. And everybody back home got very excited to see that they were doing Fox News. We were getting messages, and so there's a video of that up on our Facebook, so if you'd like to come and be our virtual friends online, then we'd really appreciate that.
That's cool.
See all kinds of things and what we're
going to do. Lift it up. You know what you're doing?
Anyway, we're going to try on now with some wedding music to slow things down just for a little bit. And this is a tune that we wrote for a friend of ours who got us out of a very sticky situation a couple of years ago. We always say that, you know, coming to the USA is one of our favourite places to come and tour because people are just so friendly all the time. The one slight exception to that rule is occasionally the gentlemen who work on the immigration desks in Chicago or the airport. They tend to be occasionally not quite so friendly, and me and Sam found this out a couple of years ago, and we enjoyed their hospitality overnight in the cells that they have there sent back to London. And meanwhile, there was still a show going on, and the girls had made it to Ohio to go and perform in the North American Festival of Wales, and they were, I think it's fair to say, they were panicking a little bit, and they called around all of the guitarists in North America that we knew, of which there was one. And Mr. Hayes Griffin, to be fair to him, he pulled it out of the bag, he dropped everything, he came running and learned the whole Callan set in about 5 minutes flat. And went on stage and performed it with them. So we really owed him big time. So when he got married a couple of months later to his lovely wife, Quinn, we decided to write them this tune. It's a special one. So this is Ace and Quinn's. Thank you.
It's really good. And you know, we've got CDs on sale and all that, and you know, we've got merch and all that kind of thing. But what we also have is our own cheese.
Oh.
But, you know, as Patrick mentioned, they don't really like us in immigration. So, we thought it's better not to chance it and bring over the cheese since that they already hate us that much already. So unfortunately, we don't have any with us tonight. I know, I know. But if you're ever in Covent Garden in London,
yes,
then here we go.
Yes.
Get some cheese. And our cheese is called Caws Calan, which simply means Calan cheese. And it is very, very good. And yeah, you can get it in Covent Garden or in Bethesda in North Wales. Or just come over to the UK and come to one of our gigs there, and then you can get cheese. And what's funny about the cheese is that it actually generally sells better than the CDs.
They don't want to bring the cheese. Bring the cheese yet.
Which is fine, you know, it's all
well,
good.
It's hard to bring the food across.
So yeah, this one
is
a bit of a homage to the fromage. And it's called Madame Fromage.
I've got a song about cheese. That was too funny.
Thank you.
Cool, diolch. We're going to finish this first half now, and then you'll know that most of the songs, you know, they're pretty depressing. You know, someone's either already dead or is about to die. But this one's a bit different because no one dies. And everyone's pretty much, they're all right, really. It's this guy, the main problem in the song is that this guy is actually looking for a wife. He's trying to pick up a lady somewhere. But he's having trouble with it because, you know, he doesn't have the right pickup lines, and he's not doing a very good job of trying to find a girlfriend or a wife at all. And, you know, especially with the Welsh women, he finds them a bit scary and a bit too fierce, because they sort of just, they won't do as they're told, and they don't seem to make his dinner properly, and they don't seem, you know, they don't want to wash his clothes or anything. So what he decides to do in the end, he goes through all these problems, and he just decides in the end it's probably easier for him if he just stays single forever. And so that's what he does, and he's very pleased with himself. And I'm sure all the Welsh women who ever met him were equally as happy when he stayed for the rest of his life. So diolch yn fawr, come and find us in the break, and we're going to finish this half with Synnwyr Song.
Time. I'm going to go five piece, you might notice on the posters, we're actually missing violinist, other violinist I had, who is on maternity leave at the moment. She had a baby not long ago, so wasn't quite able to make it out to America this time. And this is Nadolig Apple Tower, which translates as Christmas in Swansea, which is the town that she's from in Wales. And it's, she composed a kind of reminiscing about her times coming home from university to celebrate Christmas with her family.
Thank you.
we're going to stick with the live. Sound the sound of the chanting from the church. But we're not going to chant Bible verses at you tonight. We've sort of used this sound and written our own words to go with this. And it's all about Wales and just us Welsh people and what it's like to be Welsh. We are all really lucky to be fluent Welsh speakers. We're very proud of our language and our culture and our music, and we love to travel all over the world and spread our music and our songs as far and wide as we can. But it can be quite difficult when you're such a small country. It's about this big. There's only 3 million people in Wales. And when we were in Texas Irish Fest, we actually realised that Texas itself is at least 10 times the size of our entire country. And we are stuck onto the side of one of the most powerful languages and countries in the world. We're stuck right next to England. Our one border is connected to England, and so we sometimes have to fight quite hard to make sure that we're heard and that our language and our culture can continue to thrive. And so this song's all about that, and how, you know, even people like us who spend our lives promoting Welsh music and culture, even we sometimes question, are we doing enough? And we start to feel a bit guilty when we feel like maybe we're not doing quite enough, we could be doing more. So it's all about these mixed up feelings of being Welsh and proud, but also sort of the weight we feel. And I'm going to recite some poetry for you in a minute as well. Land of quite extraordinary charms. From her outline
Diolch o galon, pawb yn yr eto. Safe home, God bless.